Welcome back, everyone. Today, we're going to rig the mannequins in Unreal Engine 5. We have a bunch of options here. So if you go to Content Drawer, look in the Characters folder, you'll see in Mannequin Meshes, we have one skeleton and multiple meshes attached to it. It's four of them here. And yet again, in Mannequin UE4, we have another skeleton and with one additional mesh attached to it. This is the older Unreal Engine 4 mannequin, which still has a use, as we will see. Now, first we have to get them out of the engine. So I'm going to select Manny Simple here. And this is the mannequin that I use most often. If I go to Character, Mesh, set the mesh info from basic to detailed, you can see that it has 89 bones, of which 80 are mapped to vertices, or you can say they are wheat painted. Similarly, if you go back to the content drawer, and I open instead SKM Manny, you'll see that this one has 161 bones, of which 128 are mapped. So this is more like a metahuman character type of rig, minus the facial bones that they have. Similarly, Quinn and Simple Quinn are exact copies of SKM Manny and Manny Simple. From the perspective of rigging a character, they're exactly the same thing. So most often I'm going to use Manny Simple, which is the 89 bone version. And I will use this in conjunction with the older SK mannequin, which is from the Unreal Engine 4. Now to get them out, I can just select any of these meshes. UEFI 2 will support all of them. I will right click on it. I go to Asset Actions, Export, and I will select the file name that I want to export it as, since I've already used this file name once. So I'm just going to give it a new file name and then save. And this FBX export options open up, and then I can just click on export, and that's all there is to it. So you can just repeat the same process for all five of these meshes if you want, and we can rig all of them in Blender using UEFI 2. I'm going to select the default cube, go to data properties, and in UEFI script panel, I will click on setup scene. This is going to update the unit scale and view clipping distance. Then I can do A to select all, X to delete, and just clear the scene. Now I can do File, Import, FBX, and go to where the mannequin is. I'm going to select Manny Simple. This is the 89 bone version of the mannequin. I will deselect animation, and in Armature, I want automatic bone orientation. Then I can do Import FBX. Because of the unit scale, this is going to come in large. So I'm just going to zoom back a little bit. Now, the only thing that we want out of here is one or more of these meshes. So I'm just going to create a new scene selection. I'm going to select one of these meshes, any one will do. And then in UEFI Extra Tools, there is an Extract Mesh tool that will separate all of these mesh objects from the armature. So then I can just drag one or more of these meshes, however many I want to work with, into this other collection. And then we don't need this anymore. I'm going to create a new scene collection, select it, then do Shift A, Armature, UEFI Script, Mannequin Meta Rig Presets, and select the correct meta rig for the character. Since we're dealing with Manny 89, I'm going to select this one, but all of the others also work. This meta rig is already pre-configured and matches the character perfectly. Now we can scroll to the Generate Rig button and click on this to generate the final rig, and we can hide the meta rig for the time being. I can select the mesh, shift click on the final rig, and then do Control P to attach the mesh to our final rig with Armature Deform. Now I can select the generated rig. I will go to the UEFI script panel. These first two options are only for custom characters really, but I will make sure that I click on refresh list, and these second two options should be correct. The meta rig should be selected here, and the rig object should be selected here. Then I can scroll down to build skeleton and click on this to make this thing compatible for Unreal Engine 5. Once that is done, this character is basically ready for animation and export, and we can put the rig in front from viewport display if we want, and we can test some of these controls just to see if they are working, which they will be. And this same process can be used to rig both the Manny 161 bone version and the Quinn and Unreal Engine 4 mannequins if we wanted to. I can click on the N key to bring up this menu, and then I can drag rig layers to the top and rig main properties right underneath, and these buttons will let you control which of these controls you want visible at any time. We can also shift click on these three layers over here to make visible the export hierarchy if you want to review it or if you want to change weight painting on these export bones. To export this character, we can go to object mode, select the mesh, shift click on the rig, then do file, export, FBX, select the file name for export, enable selected objects. This is going to exclude the camera, lights, and anything else that might be in the scene. In the armature options, we want to export only the deformed bones. We do not want to add any leaf bones, and we are not dealing with animation right now. And then we can do export FBX. Now we will create a second export with Unreal Engine based joint rolls. If we wanted to export directly to the Unreal Engine mannequin, the original one, to do that, make sure you have a backup of your blend file, because this operation is not compatible with Blender or Rigify and we can only export from this point on. So I'm going to make sure that this move twist option is set correctly between the Unreal Engine 5 mannequin or the Unreal Engine 4 mannequin if you were rigging that. So these two options are actually different. Then I will just click on this once and now I can do export again, file, export, FBX. I will select a different file name just to indicate that this is with the Unreal Engine rolls on the bones. And again, the same thing, we want to do selected objects and armature. We want only deformed bones. We don't want to add any leaf bones or any animation. So we're just going to do export FBX. And now we have two export files and we can restore from the backup to re-enable animation in this file. Importing this character into Unreal Engine 5 involves setting up post-process animation blueprint to automate twist movement. It's more complicated than simply importing the file, as in the previous version of Unreal Engine. Be sure to check the next video where we will go over the entire process step by step. I hope you enjoyed this video and thank you for watching.